In this After Effects tutorial, we will create a text animation using scale and opacity values. Instead of animation, the letters of the words you write in the workspace one by one. We will control them from a single point using the animate feature in After Effects. By improving your knowledge of animate, we will be able to create practical and professional looking text effects. After opening the After Effects program, you can either say new composition from here, or you can click on new composition under the composition menu. Now, let's open a 9020 by 1080 project and click OK. Then let's write a text on our scene. I right click, I choose new text and type a text here. I'm writing scenography. If you want, you can center this text both vertically and horizontally on the page from the align panel. After writing our text, let's give movement to the text. Our text is here. We have one text layer here. I click on the arrow on the left of this text layer. In the properties that open, you will see an animate option on the right side of the text. Just to the right of animate, you will see a small arrow. I click on this arrow once. There are two values that are important for us: scale value and opacity value. Because they will come from nothing and they will come from big. They will create a text you see right now. Both scale and opacity values are important for me here. I click once on the scale value and then I select the text again. This time I select the opacity value. As you can see, there will be two separate effect sections here. We need to set it to animator 1 and animator 2. Because if you select this and click add here, opacity will appear here. We don't want that. I undo this with Ctrl Z. Now the first thing we will do is to keyframe. We will give keyframe to the animate property which has scale in it. But we will give it to the range selector. I click on the arrow on the left side of the range selector and offset is the important thing for us here. I click once on the keyframe button of offset. It assigned a keyframe here, but the percentage is not 0. I set it to be minus 100 to start with, and I go forward a few seconds and create the value of minus 100 as plus 100. The next thing I need to do is the scale value. If it is 100%, the letters won't grow, but you can increase it. And I want to say these are not fixed values. You will need to change them according to your own project, your text, and the word length. Instead of 100, here I make it 200. And when I play it, I get a result like this. It is not what we want right now, but it doesn't matter. This is how it works. Animator 1 is done for us. Now we choose the animator 2. Let's open the range selector again, and from here, when all the letters are here, when all the letters are capitalized, I give a keyframe to the offset value, and at the end, I give 100% to the offset value around that other keyframe. It created two keyframes. As you can see, there is no difference, because I didn't make any changes to the opacity value. I'm setting the opacity value to 0%. I'm going to play it back to see how the edit we made turned out. Let's see what happened. Yes, as you can see, as I mentioned at the beginning, it is actually the way I wanted it to be at the beginning. You can get faster, slower results by spacing these keyframes or decreasing them. I'm looking at the result again. I press the letter U. The letter U shows me only the keyframes that have keyframes in them. So I'm hiding the other things that I'm not interested in. I'm hiding them. Now let's put these two on top of each other. And let's zoom in on this one a little bit more. And if we adjust this one so that it is in the middle, I'll get a quick result. That was actually our main goal. It is up to you improve it. If we activate the motion blur option here and activate the motion blur on the layer, we can get a more realistic animation. The motion blur effect here will take it away from digitally and create a more cinematic effect. I can increase the scale value here a little bit more. For example, 300. So, it's coming from a larger size, that's not necessary. Around 200 or 170 is appropriate for this text size. You can also change this text later if you want. If you change it, nothing will change because your effect is already ready. We can use this type of effect to write a name, for example. Let's put an image like this in the background and minimize our text and write it below. When we align the text to the left, you can intervene with the size of the text here if you want. And after need that, Let's see how it looks right now. And underneath that, I'm going to select this layer with Ctrl D and create a new layer with Ctrl D. I'm going to set a position for this one, and this one will be at the bottom. What shall we call it? Let's call it a profession. Let's call it a graphic designer. We can do the layout of this one right away, like this. Let's even make it a little bit 100% here, so that we can see what we are doing better. We can make the placement and so on more beautiful. Even if you open the letter width of this a little bit, it might look better to the eye, like that. How does it look right now? If we move it a little bit further forward on this layer, so it starts from the end of the name at the top, it might look better. I might look good with these settings. Let's see. Yes, not bad. So, how does this look on the full page? I think it's not bad for an example. With the text effect I have shown on this page, you can create different looking text effects for yourself. Combining them with each other can produce beautiful results. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.